What's good, guys? Dan here, and I've been tagged by my friend Pat, aka Piao Lang. And Pat wants to know, what knife do I want to carry but can't, for legal reasons or otherwise? And Pat, that's a very interesting question, man. Thanks for the tag. Thanks for asking. I got a couple different blades. So first of all, I'm in Florida, and if you take a look at the statutes, now, first of all, this is not legal advice. I actually haven't looked at the statutes in a while. I don't have the exact language in front of me, but I believe the standard is that you are allowed to carry a pocket knife. And pocket knife. So that is the $1,000 question, the $1 million question. What is a pocket knife under the law? Because, you know, for people who aren't knife people, I'm sure they've got a totally different idea in their head as to what would be a pocket knife within that law and what we, you know, more knife nut kind of people, what we would think is a pocket knife. So here's kind of my take on it. Now, of course, really the way to find out would be to look at other cases, do some more research, figure out if there's any better standard, a little more specific, a little more exact, but I haven't done that research. I don't really care to. And once again, this is not legal advice in any way, shape, or form. So just me, just kind of mental musings on this. I would think that you're going to be absolutely fine with anything with a 3-inch or under blade. That's probably going to be considered a pocket knife. No problem. Now, where you might get into trouble is where you're creeping up more towards 4 inches. And perhaps more importantly, it's kind of the overall look of the knife. If you take in some other kind of factors, such as, say, the name or the make or the model. Like, for example, we got this Emerson CQC-13 Combat Bowie, and it's a bigger knife. It's got a 3¾-inch long blade, and it looks pretty nasty. It's got that, you know, you saw the video, the review perhaps, where it's got that tip. It's got the razor sharp belly designed for law enforcement, military. If you take a look at the name, CQC-13, CQC stands for Close Quarter Combat, and then the whole Combat Bowie name, I mean, it just doesn't do it any favors if you're on trial, you're in a courtroom trying to defend your carrying around of a common pocket knife, and if it's like, you know, brought out to be by some sort of Combat Bowie and this, that, and the other, and maybe they show some screenshots of the Emerson website or something, and you got all these American flags and skulls and, you know, the whole high speed, low drag, Emerson smooth operator thing going on there. I don't know. It might look bad. So, not going to say it, you know, either way. It just could. So, I would feel less comfortable carrying something like this than, say, a mini Griptilian, or heck, even a full-size Griptilian. I think, you know, it's just because you could probably make a stronger argument that this is a pocket knife, like a pure kind of utility knife, and this has got some stuff pointing to suggest that maybe it's not. So, I don't know. I still carry the CQC-13. What can I say? Probably treading on some thin ice if something were to happen. I don't know. More likely than other knives. Let's put it that way. And here's another example. This is a knife that I don't really carry, but this is a very big folding knife. This is the Benchmade Skirmish, and at least a 4-inch blade on there. You can see it makes even the CQC-13 look small. So that is one that probably is not going to be classified as a pocket knife. You know, technically it is, but if you dig into the statute, if you dig into the case law and stuff, I'm sure they draw the line somewhere, and you might be getting there with this. Now, another classification, another kind of knife that I'd love to carry but can't, would be a fixed blade. You know, like a good size fixed blade. This is, of course, this is the Spyderco Street Bowie. You've seen this in a few video responses and tags and stuff. This thing is just wicked. I'd love to carry it. Probably not to butter my toast or anything, but it'd just be cool. You know, it's just a cool knife. And unfortunately, in my current state, I can't. And by state, I mean, you know, kind of legal status. Same with this Cold Steel SRK. This is a pretty big knife. I probably wouldn't want to EDC this, but certainly there's other fixed blades that are a little bit smaller that I would probably be interested in carrying, but can't. Now, what I could do is I could apply for a concealed weapons license or a concealed carry permit, and in the state of Florida, what that would grant me is the right to, of course, carry a firearm concealed, but also pretty much any kind of knife, fixed blades, large folders, short swords, whatever, you know, whatever. If you can conceal it, my understanding is that it's legal to carry. I don't know about automatics, but I don't really have a huge interest in carrying automatic knives. I mean, they're cool, but I don't feel like I'm really being deprived of anything, at least practically speaking, by not carrying an automatic. I feel like most of the modern folders are just as fast, if not faster, than an automatic. I mean, case in point, this Emerson with the Wave certainly is. So those are some knives and thoughts on knives that I can and can't carry. And I hope it's been kind of fun. Hopefully not too weird or boring. But anyhow, Pat, thank you so much for tagging that. And I would like to pay it forward, tag a few people. I wanted to kind of get some guys who are international, not in the United States, involved, because I'm curious to see what you guys want to carry but can't. So first up, I've got Kevin the Screen Killer from the Netherlands. He's got some sweet knives. Kevin, what do you want to carry but can't? Is there anything? And next up, Stefan, ST Schmalhaus. Brother, I know you got a lot of cool gentleman's folders and practical fixed blade knives for outdoor use, but I have to wonder, is there something in your collection that you want to carry but can't? Maybe it's a really cool gentleman's folder of some sort. I have no idea. So, but I would love to watch the video if you felt like making one. So I'm going to tag you. And Thomas Smith from Canada. Brother, I'd be curious. I know they got some different rules and stuff up there in Canada. Finally, Jai of Spam, who I do not think is from, I think he is in the United States, but be curious anyways. All right, guys, that is it. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks again, Pat, and everybody take care.